My thinking is, what is, in your opinion, is the importance or the role of grandparents in this fact? Do you think their presence or absence are relevant, important, or contributory for the welfare of the family?
You see, this question, I think, should worry or bother all the Hindu families in the West, especially in the West, because we are in a period of transition. In India or in East Africa where we lived, the idea of an extended family was natural and normal. The grandparents always lived with the young couples, young family. They always lived together. And the grandchildren were brought up by the grandparents, and they both benefited. The grandparents want this company of children because they're at the same IQ level, so they love these children. And the children love somebody to pull the leg off, you know, and mess up and, you know, play with. Your children need grandparents, because it gives them extra freedom and tremendous love at the same time. So this was a marvelous symbiosis between the two groups, the very young and the very elderly in the same family. And you see, it's not only the fact that the children feel tremendous, you know, affinity for the grandparents are a storehouse of marvelous wisdom. We sometimes forget that, you know, sometimes we ridicule them, we push them aside, but they have tremendous amount of wisdom, and this is lost as well. And what is this wisdom? The wisdom is this: it is telling us that some of the issues, some of the ideas that we have in family values, some of the family values that we used to kind of really adhere to, are now being lost. What are these values? Like, say, the idea of some kind of discipline, idea of respect. All these things came naturally in family circles. And these two words appear perhaps, you know, old-fashioned, but they are still crucial in a modern society. Because if the family members begin to show respect for each other, observe certain discipline regarding how they behave with the other members of the family, that family will work well together. And these are the kind of values that came with these elderly people, with these grown-ups in the family. And this would, in a way, automatically bring in natural cohesion in the family unit. If the family unit is held together through all these lovely ideas, through family values, then that family unit becomes a solid brick on which society can be built. Society is built up of lots of family units. They are like bricks. So if the brickwork itself is solid, very well, you know, linked up, joined up, then the structure will be solid as well. Well, if the brickwork is cracking up, then the whole society will pay a price. So this is why I think family values and the idea of making sure the elderly people are not rejected or dejected in the family, but given dignity to stay amongst the youngsters and participate and offer their wisdom, should be encouraged, and we should not lose sight of it.